Hey, it's Jaime with Echo Real Estate Advisors. Welcome to the channel that provides actionable content to help your business grow. Don't forget to subscribe, as every month I give away one of my Facebook, Google, and YouTube courses away for free as a thank you for being a subscriber. All right, today we're looking at free lead generation strategies that will bring you free leads online. Now, I want to put some qualifiers out there first. They are strategies that you can do free that you don't have to pay a single dime for. And these are activities, strategies that are for the online world. That's what the purpose of this video is. And beyond that, these are going to be a bit more unique. They're going to challenge you and really invite you into the creative space. As you know, the landscaping when it comes to marketing, regardless of the industry that you're in, has changed drastically.
Boy, that escalated quickly.
Really, that's what I want to cover today. And more specifically for the real estate industry, if you are used to hearing do open houses, cold call, door knock, know that that has its place, but that's not what we're going to cover today. Today, we're going to cover the concept of answering a question. Today, we're going to cover the concept of providing value. So we hear that often way too much, providing value, but at the end of the day, you say nothing. You do nothing. You just do a self-promotion where a person's description or interpretation or meaning of providing value is, hey, I'm here and I'm going to sell your house. We provided a service, but did you really provide value? And beyond that, even before you get the listing, even before you start working with that buyer, are you providing value to where if they never spoke to you, if they never emailed you or called you, did you provide value? I think that's the litmus test, where you can tell people how good you are and how amazing you are. That's just more self-promotion. You don't necessarily provide value. So whenever I'm saying getting free leads, I am approaching it from that standpoint. And more specifically, to illustrate this point, let's say in the online world, people are asking how to sell a house. Now, you as a real estate professional, you run into that all the time. You get that question on the phone. You get that question at a meetup. You get that question anytime somebody is ready to get their home sold or have a listing or want to buy a house. Like, well, how do I buy a house on the other end? But more specifically, let's stay to how to sell a house. Now, the concept that I really want to drive home is, one, answering that question and providing value to it, but two, the creative part is, where are you going to answer that? Where are you going to address that? Where are you going to provide value? This is where the free component comes into play. You are providing value by answering that question, and then two, the free part is you are doing that in the online space. So I'm going to give you some very clear examples of where you can do that. First, let's look at Quora. If you're not familiar of Quora, Quora is a community where you can ask a question and get answers. So I'm not suggesting that you go and ask this question because it's already been asked, but what I'm suggesting is you go and take similar style questions, even this question right here, as you'll see, and address the question, provide value. So what you'll see here when you type in how to sell a house as an example, what is the process for selling a house? Well, there's 53 answers. So when you solve somebody's problem, when you provide somebody the value, they feel I'm not gonna say they feel a need, but they do feel indebted to you. There's that reciprocity that comes into play. Quora, that's something that I've been on for about 2 years now, just answering questions, providing value, and really approaching it from that standpoint. And it's been good in getting my name out. It's been good in establishing some level of authority when it comes to that respect. And you can see that different variations of the question is being posed. So this is very similar to Reddit. Most people are familiar with Reddit, which I do have it highlighted up here as well. Let me just move it over here. Reddit, very same concept and very same style, except it's a bit more complex. This is straightforward. You ask the question, then you answer the question, You see a question that's asked, and then you answer the question. You're providing value, you're answering what they're wanting to know, and there is a bit of self-promotion. There's a you can do a little bit more self-promotion here than in Reddit, but you can have addressing the need and doing a little bit of self-promo so people know that you're in the space and that you can possibly help them. Reddit, this one is a little bit different. This one is more of a, is a bit more complex. I'm gonna suggest that you watch some other videos on how to appropriately post in Reddit because it's a different animal. They're not as kind, I'll put it mildly, as the Quora community when it comes to, if you're doing a lot of self-promotion and it's very evident, you're not gonna last on Reddit very long. So, how to sell a house. Very same concept, providing value. It's a community. People hear more than on Quora. They are self-policing. But when you provide value and approach Reddit in the correct way, then it can really produce some good results for you. So that is another online platform that you get to provide that value. And it's free for you. Just a little bit of investment in time goes a long way. Now, a medium that you're very familiar with because you're seeing it right now, YouTube, how to sell a house. This is a very popular phrase. This is a very popular search. This is a very popular question that if you can provide value in addressing this question where people are a bit more engaged, entertained would be great, but more than anything, you can address the question succinctly. That's gonna go a long way, and it's something that you can share in your social media platform and establish a bit of authority. Not a lot of real estate agents are in the YouTube world. They just aren't. A few videos ago, I made mention of that. I do believe YouTube is the most underutilized platform out there for real estate professionals today, hands down. So that's why I'm doubling down, tripling down, quadrupling down this year. That and LinkedIn, but I'll do a LinkedIn video later on how to get leads off of that. So, again, it's the very same concept of addressing this value piece and actually providing value. Yes, you can do a little bit of self-promotion and it's gonna help build the authority, but you're not out there saying, hey, use me to sell your house, or I'm the best person to sell your house. Well, you're showing, you're demonstrating by fully capturing the knowledge that you have and presenting it to other people. So that is another medium that is working quite well. Again, you're kind of seeing it in action right now. And then Facebook, tried and true, how to sell a house. You're gonna see a lot of posts, and the more that you can provide value in that front, the better off you're going to be. If you're posting on your business page, how to sell a house, the actual process of selling a house, that's gonna go a long way. If you're posting that in your personal profile, again, you're providing the actual steps, not saying, hey, use me to sell your house, or hey, use me to buy a house. You are providing value on how the process works. And by proxy, people are gonna take notice. People are gonna see you as the authority and are gonna reach out to you to help them whenever the time comes. You just need to be a little bit more consistent. This isn't a instantaneous thing that's going to happen. It's more of a slow burn, but at the end of the day, you tally up enough clout out there, professional clout out there, that it's gonna start really exponentially pick up. So I can personally attest to that. And if you're not posting on the business page or on your personal page, then I would encourage you to post something on garage groups or buy sell groups. Again, not more of a self promo, but more of a providing value. There's a lot of community groups out there that have formed that do need the right information. And you can be that person to provide it. Again, value, value, value. I want to make that distinction very clear because people still think that providing value is them actually doing their job. Them actually doing the service. That's not providing value. That's just you doing the service. And beyond that, just you advertising your face and saying, I'm the best real estate agent in Tarrant County or in Dallas County. Well, one's probably not true. Let's be real with that. Chances are that's probably not true. Two, it's super subjective. There's no way for people to know that. Or you to know that. You're just saying that because you're used to it. You're used to it. And I fall on that as well. I mean, I'm not immune to it. So let's just be real with each other. Let's be authentic with each other, because that's what's happening. Let's move on. I got into too much of a high horse there. Pinterest, another place to provide value. Pinterest is a bit more complex. Again, this is a beast that I've been trying to take down for a little while now, and I just haven't been as successful. YouTube, I think I've gotten into a little good rhythm there, but Pinterest eats my lunch. It eats my lunch, but at the end of the day, there's some agents out there that are very successful with it in actually providing the whole value. And this was generated from a place of giving, from a place of generating value. Tried and true tips to sell a house quickly. Professional staging checklist. Eight inexpensive tips to get your house sold fast. Behind these people, I can tell you it's professionals in that industry. I can tell you that they're professional stagers. I can tell you that they're realtors. I can tell you that they're, if this was an insurance type of a deal, I can tell you that those people would be insurance agents. I can tell you that the people that are writing this are actually in that profession because they're actually wanting to drive in traffic and drive awareness to what they're doing, providing value, answering the question, as you see here, how to sell a house. They give you the tips, which would, once you go over to that board, they're going to tell you how, one, they're going to answer it, and then how they can contact, or you can contact them. And then the old how to sell a house on Google. Now, this one's a bit more difficult. This is where people fall into a trap where, well, if I want some passive leads, if I want those leads that I don't have to pay any money for, that are going to be there for the long run, I need to rank on Google. That is something that we're very familiar with at this point. However, it is a tough road. This one is difficult. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. It takes a good amount of time of knowing what you're doing, and it needs to be pretty good quality content. So look at the competition that you're with. Not to discourage you, but I want to shoot you straight on this. We have how to sell your house. Our friends over at Open Door made that. And Open Door's tips on how to sell your house is not the same as a real estate agent's, because their motto is more of a flipper. How to sell a house, Dave Ramsey. How to sell your house, tips for a fast sale, Open Door. Then you're gonna see Zillow's probably at some point, Homelight, a lead aggregator in my mind, Investopedia, Money Crasher, Zillow, Trulia, Real Estate US News, The Balance, WikiHow, Realtor. So this requires a good amount of work. Again, not trying to sugarcoat it, nor am I trying to dissuade you from using them. I'm providing another way to get free lead generation strategies for real estate, just free real estate leads, free any industry, insert any industry here, and the same methodology applies across the board. Now, I do want to provide value outside of just saying, hey, well, figure it out. I'm not going to suggest that you go and spend money. I'm not going to suggest that you go and research everything that you can about SEO and try to rank here. If this is a strategy that you're going to pursue, which for me, I'm not really doing this part of it. I'm more on the YouTube world, as you can see by this video. What I would suggest, if you're trying to get on the SEO side of things, if you're trying to get ranked on Google, if I were you, what I would do would be align myself with a larger name like the Dallas News or the Star Telegram, which is a Tarrant County or a DFW newspaper. I would align myself with those websites that have ranked highly in our authority sites in Google. And I would offer to write an article for them, or I would offer to be on a show with them. I would offer to provide something of value so I can attach my brand, my name, to their authoritative sites. So how does that look in real life? I would reach out to an editor at the Dallas Morning News as an example, and I would offer to present my case on the state of the real estate industry for 2019? Let's just say 2020. Where I think the real estate market is going in 2020, I would make that I would make the article. First, I would make the article, if I'm going to be candid with you, I would first make the article, and then I would try to pitch it everywhere else. If you notice, I said 2020, and that gives me 6 months to put it on the board somewhere, which if somebody is interested enough, maybe Dallas won't be interested, but Fort Worth could be. Arlington, Mansfield, Frisco, Collin County is broad enough to where I have a good amount of time to put this on a shelf somewhere, ideally in an article somewhere. And again, it's an authoritative website that not only are they going to print it, but they're going to put it on their online world, and chances are that it could rank over here. But again, that's more of a strategy on how I would approach it if I was going to go and really invest in the SEO world. But yeah, these are some examples on how to provide value and address the questions that are happening every single day in a free way that at the end of the day, you're going to be getting some leads in a passive sense. These are evergreen. These are going to live and continue to get more traction, as opposed to you going and having that open house, as opposed to you cold calling, as opposed to you door knocking, because if you're not in front of that door, then you're not going to get that lead. If you're not making that phone call, you're not going to get that lead. If you're not a, you see what I'm saying? This whole passive and online and free way of getting leads is real. And this is how you do it.